Women's Basketball Weekly Update with Head Coach Aaron Johnston. Let's recap last week. 100-62 win against Western Illinois. 38-point win. Really started quick. Tyler Irwin, really good first quarter. Mason Miller, really good second quarter. All-around good win on a special day for your senior class.
Yeah, it was a great day. You know, everything went about as well as we could have hoped. And really going into that game, that last regular season home game for the seniors, there's always a bunch of different emotion you can see as a coach. And over the years, every group handles that a little bit differently. But Macy, Maddie, and Sid were just rock solid like they've been all year long. You could tell it was on their mind, and you could tell they knew it was coming. But how they practiced and how they led their teammates, they just took all the stress and all that pressure off of everybody and just allowed everyone to kind of go out and play and make it like any other game. And we started off as well as we could. Tyler had a great first quarter there, scored over 30 points in that quarter. We defended really well, and it just was ended up being a great day and a great win. But just really big credit for those seniors for getting everybody in that place.
With the win, you captured the regular season title the first time in 5 years. For all the accolades that, over the last few years, that's impressive. And the seniors are really happy they accomplished that, they said after the game.
Yeah, you know, it was a big win. They wanted to have that chance. They want to win a conference title every year. And it's a hard thing to do. And I've always felt that way, not just this year, not just the last few years. To be at your best for a couple of months, not just one weekend or you put it together for a couple of days, you've got to fight through, in this case, some injuries where we have people that are out. You've got the travel that goes into it. You're playing everybody twice. I mean, there's a lot of factors that go into it that make it tough. In the last couple of years, we've been right there, literally a few possessions away from possibly winning that. And I think that's why this year that senior group wanted it so much. They've been knocking on the door so many times. They wanted to finally get through. But to see them get that outright championship was a fun day. But to get there, you know, they all played really well in the game. Tylee had such a big game, double-double, a bunch of assists, bunch of steals. She's playing phenomenal right now. Tegan also had another 17-point performance and just really good with what she did. So to get, you know, everybody playing on a high level, accomplish that goal for the whole team, but particularly the seniors, that really made it a great weekend.
So when you look at this team now, 15-1 overall in the Summit League, 13 straight wins. It's been quite a season and one of the best, especially in recent history.
Yeah, we've had a remarkable year, and I felt that way for a while. The conference title is a nice plus to keep that going, but we've played such good basketball. I could be off on a number or two now. Things have changed since maybe last week when I looked at it, but I think almost 10 of our non-conference opponents were rated in the top 100 of the RPI. That's a really tough schedule. And to come out, you know, with so many wins like we did and some tough close losses just says a lot about how this team has played. And they've been challenged in a lot of ways, but they've responded really well. And we've done it as a balanced team. We've relied on a lot of different people. We've had to overcome some adversity throughout the year. We've had to overcome some tough losses. But every time something kind of gets up in front of this team, they just keep going and keep their head down and continue to improve and find ways to win.
As you look forward here, we got the Summer League Tournament, which begins Saturday. It'll be kind of a unique week with spring break, no class in session, but a little extra preparation maybe for the team to get ready.
Yeah, it's a different week. You know, we usually have school going on, and then next week's spring break. But this year, just calendar changes, and so we have a little different routine. I think it's nice. You know, we've been battling through a bunch of things here in the last several weeks, from injuries to just a lot of illness. Every day, we've got different people out, and that includes some coaches at times. So we've had plenty of things that we've had to get through here recently. So maybe a little bit extra time comes at the right time of year for us. But it's really this week trying to find ways to get just laser focused on playing well on Saturday. You know, a lot of times people ask if we're getting ready for a 3-day, and we're trying to play as well as we can in that next game. That is the only thing on our radar. And then when that game's over, we'll see where we're at and get ready for what comes next. But I'm really pleased with where the team is at. I think we'll be healthy. I think we'll be, you know, recovered and ready to go come this weekend.
Maya Selwyn didn't play Saturday. Do you have a status or an update on her status?
Yeah, I mean, she's still day-to-day, but we would expect her back this weekend. You know, whether that's right away or whether we ease her into it, we'll have to see. But certainly we expect her back this weekend. She's worked really hard at it and just hasn't really been healthy for a long time. I know she's feeling really good, though, and I think really excited to get back at it.
Look at your first matchup Saturday at noon. You play against Purdue-Fort Wayne, a team you played just a couple weeks ago here at home. They got rolling a little bit in that first half, but you put the clamps down in that second half. They're playing better this year. What do you see out of them scouting for Saturday's matchup?
Well, they present the same challenges they did a few weeks ago when we struggled with them. They have enough shooters on the perimeter where they can make shots, and that's what they did against us. They hit threes to continue to keep that game close. And then they have enough size and ability to score inside where you really have to have a plan to defend that area. They really can score inside and out. And they bring some strength and some physicality to the defensive side of the floor. And I think that, you know, prevents us from getting some of our post touches and things that we want too. So we'll have to have a good plan there. I think the other thing you have to be mindful of going in this time of year, people are changed. Even in this 1 week, there'll be new wrinkles that teams put in. We certainly look to do that. Others will do that too. So even though you might feel good about a previous outing, it might be a whole different plan that needs to happen after the ball goes up on Saturday. Plus it's tournament time. Everybody has a new sense of urgency and a new sense of excitement. So anything that's happened in the past really doesn't help us at all on Saturday. We've got to go down there and play well on that day. And our focus will be to get there. I really like where we're at. But we'll have to play well on that day.
As you said, it is March Madness. You look at the past, you've won 8 of these tournaments in the last 10 years. What's going to be the key to winning 9-11?
Well, very few things go as expected. Seeds very rarely hold. Oftentimes in that, you know, as a tournament moves on, you have different upsets and different matchups than people would have predicted, and I would suspect that'll happen this year. So for us, it's about just staying laser focused on what do we have to do now. Every day this week as we prepare to get ourselves ready, how do we give ourselves the best chance? And then on Saturday, when that ball goes up, be ready for the unexpected. You just really have no idea how it's going to go. Find a way to be resilient and stay in there. So we're looking forward to it. It's just such a fun atmosphere, fun event. Jackrabbit fans, Jackrabbit Nation make it one of the best tournaments in the country. We want to go down there and play well for all the people there that are there supporting that event and certainly keep the momentum going that we've had for a long time.